We speak about the possibility to help Latvia in Syria, and we use in this experiment Python with the Django framework. First to start. Hello everyone. Oh, sorry, because I don't see the others. Okay. I present myself. I'm Nicola Bavarone. I'm the owner and I'm obviously Latvian developer in ByteLabs. I apologize for my English. I'm sorry for this. I just started with the Fabiola request for our giant female. I selected Margaret Hamilton as he started the software engineering, and I selected Margaret for this. Okay. Another first to start, I think all of you have seen the static activity. Then in this presentation, there are some cut items, and if you want, you can copy and send after to this mail. Okay, this is not valid to use because it's just to explain. Then, why Python in Compatrio? The aim was to have a host or HMI. There are two serial type. The newest serial have also the HMI cable. Then you have a graphical interface, and you can configure an application also for output on the monitor linked. In the older serial, this is not. But in general, the aim of this application is to have a separated application to help also Labvio in database management in the HMI. The other topic is to have something to access with every device. Then we start with this experiment. Actually, the experiment I will share with you just a moment. I will share with you our Okay. Okay. This is the output that we have now installed on Sirio and communicate with LabVIEW. This is the interface created. Then we can have table to have the device type, monitor, and this is what we have now. But what is this? We can back. Some difficult to okay. 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 Then we have selected Django as in Python because Django is a framework MVC, MTV for the Python for the Django user, and he have just read this database support. The database support, the admin panel is just ready when you create the table. Accrued, then create, read, update, delete table is just ready. And it's based on Python. The model is this one. You can see we have a model. That's it's the aim of the model is create the data. The controller in Python become the view, and the view become the template. The view is the scope of the view is to handle the business logic, okay. And the templates is the output on the HTML file. The file under the Django is ULS and is the Python code that receives the HTTP request and pass the request the select, okay, and the URLs is okay, so and the root the request on the correct view. The view contain the business logic and decide how the output decide the output and what to do with the request. The models is the aim of the model is to define by a class the data structure and then define the table for DB. Templates at the end is a file HTML that contain the renderization of the code generated by the view. Now, the model is the model has presented how you can show. We create a model under the model Pi, as you can see, and this generate after the make migration command, it generate the SQL code that create the table. Then I can decide the table, but using just the Django framework. It's not important what database we use. Um, A viewer is possible. The viewer contain the decision, but it is possible to out the output of the viewer can be directly. Then, as you see, the code HTML is just inside the view code. Then, generate a response directly on the as a response, or it can be use the view to fill the template, as you can see, template the home HTML, hello world can return under is filled under the home HTML. This is a template. After the template, I can see if someone have a question, because I can see in the presentation, I can
There's
see the
a question from Michael. He asked, it's design service run on Clio itself.
Sorry?
The example service run on Clio itself.
Yes. After this explanation, we go in how we install Django and Python in the Clio. All this one is created under the Clio. I cannot, if I listen, because I can see the chat. Okay, I'm sorry for the sound. The CRUD table, all the table is just ready under the admin panel. Then, after the finish create my project in Django, I have just ready the Django administration panel with all the table based on CRUD. Then I can create, insert the data, read, update, or delete row. Okay, now how we can do this in Clio. The first step you need to do is enable SSH under with Max in the compact trio. Then you have a select. When you discover your Clio, you have a flag to set to enable SSH. Then you need sorry, but I can show the presentation together your chat. Then you need a SSH terminal. We can select the PuTTY. It's very easy to use. Only need to point in the address with the port 22 and select SSH flag. But when you edit the code, we have some issue because Patty is only terminal with Visual Studio Code and other editor. We cannot directly access to the CDO by the IDE. Then we have select mob extern because is under the same is both a terminal and editor and without any completion code and so on, but is help us to directly connect on the CDO to modify the file, and in the same time we have also terminal to use. Then we have choice this one to when the Django is installed. Okay. The first step is to connect with a Linux shell with after you need to log in on the shell with the same login of the CDO. Then it's needed to create admin account with, for example, user and password, because by default, CDO don't have password, is without password. Then you need to create. Then you can log in Linux shell, and now you are inside the Linux shell. Now you can, after you are in the Python shell, you have the command. You can install Python. By default, is not installed the Python. Then the Linux RT uses the OPKG package manager, and you can write the two command update, OPKG update, and install Python. If you want some detail after this presentation, I have all the link on one in one document. Different. Okay, after you have installed the Python, good approach is, do you have any memory limitation in getting more Python libraries? Yes, the risk is memory limitation, because in CDO we don't have a lot of memory, but and this for this we speak about the virtual environment now, because the right selection for this job is to use Docker. Docker is a create container, then is very modern approach. Then we can create also is useful to share something just read. But we have select the old method. Then we create a virtual environment that is divide all dependency, okay? Why we create a virtual environment? Because we create a space without any dependency for each installation of Python or other code. other package. Then, as you, Theodore, I think the interpretation of Theodore is this, the memory problem to fill memory in the CDO. We don't have any issue of memory, but we don't use Docker. We use just virtual end. That is take not a lot of space. Is the also Anaconda create some package that we are not interested in it. Then we preferred to install directly a virtual end. That is just ready on the Python. Okay. To create a virtual space, we write Python. Pay attention because after the Python installation, the name is can be different to call. If is the first installation of Python, typically Python is the right name. But if you have different installation of Python, for example, 2.7 or the 3, you can decide if you want Python 2, Python 3, then you need to call with the correct name. But Python, minus M, env, and after the name of your space, for example, Django, or the name you want. And with this command, you have created the virtual environment, but the virtual environment is not active enough. To active the virtual environment, you need to go under the folder bin that's in CDO in Linux. You can write directly after created the virtual environment. You can write directly source and bin activated is the path of to call this command. And you see you see that is activated the virtual environment because the parentheses is the okay it appear under the parentheses. Okay. Now you have a free space, okay, of Python. No package is inside the virtual environment. But now is empty space. Then we start to install only the package we need. The first package is install Django. Then we can write Python pip using pip as install manager for package manager for Python. Then we use pip install Django. With this instruction, we install the last version of Django framework. After this command, we can create, if you use the Django REST framework, is a package that we have used to create a serialization to speak with the compat trio code, the labio code, we speak with Django by the web API created. Then we install also Django REST framework. Okay, by the side of the LabVIEW, the only need to speak the IntelliJ job is based on Python and Django and Django RESTful, because by the side of LabVIEW, we need only HTTP client to access to the REST. And we have used the JSON test by GDP Science as a library to serialization the JSON. The JSON string that is sent to post or get and all the REST command. Then this is very helpful for me because it's very work in Python, Django, but after we have no more code to handle database, to handle the interface, no OSPC need to create, then I think is comfortable. And also Django framework allow you to select in is support a lot of database. Then we start with the SQLite that is just installed with the framework, but we can choose change the code, also another database. It just supported, no need to change the code. And the LabVIEW is not touched for this. It's very, for me, in my opinion, is comfortable. This is a view of the web API created. Django REST framework create also the documentation is just read then, and also the test unit for the API. Then is another point to because it's very comfortable. And then here we have all the list. I think I can share with you after this meet. If you ask me, I will share the presentation with this is the list of all the link of material used. Some that help is the NI. And I acknowledge that help us to configure to also for the package for some something that's no work. It's very helpful. There is the frequently asked question and the acknowledge in Linux RT device that is very helpful. And the other is speak about the material used for this one. Okay. If you have another time, I can. Okay. In Django, we can create Django project. Just the approach is just to go in the virtual environment and write the command Django admin start project and the name of the project, for example, Compact Trio project. Then after created a project, you have just ready the server. Then to start the server, you call the manage.py and run server. Start the server of Django. You see the URL of the server. Then you have the first stage. The project was created. Then you need to create an app. An app in Django is is an application under a project. Then our app, for example, we have two apps under our project. The first app is the Django app, then by URL to point by user, point with URL in this app. And the other app is the app created for the RESTful to speak with Sirio. Then the first step is to create you need to create the app to create the table under the database. Then manage.py, startup, and the name of your app. Now the app is created and you need to modify your project, and you can open the project, the file of the project. We have used in offline, by offline, we created the first project, and after we copied this in Sirio. Okay. We have used Visual Studio Code because the other editor is a lot of mistake in auto completion. That's for myself, that I'm not an expert. Just old, and I don't remember the text. It's very easy because with competition of the support of Visual Code is very good. Then we open we go in the setting. The first is to go in the setting by add the new application. We need to edit the setting file. It's called setting.py, and is the configuration file for this Django application. Then there is a section with the URL pattern. This is just the URL pattern. But after you have added the application on the setting.py, you go in the URL pattern to create the first URL. What is the URL to access in by starting for the IP, the URL to start in, for example, in the application. Then we add the first URL, first app for me, and include the first app wireless. This is the learn to Django that the path is this one. Then when we receive this path, he select he select the pattern to select the view. In this example, we created just a template that write some code, and the view is the same under the first app. Then is the only one view. Then we can start newly we go in the terminal, we restart the server, and we obtain the first in the path first app, follow the first app, we have the code we have created under the view is the under the template, sorry, is just a HTML page. Okay, this is the set API. I mistake, sorry. This is the first. And the setting is here. Set API, the first Django application was added here. We can select also the name of the engine, of the database engine, the language, and other setting. Okay. Now, after to complete the application and to create the admin panel, you need to create write the code manage.py migrate. This is the command that create the table for the application and to admin is the table to admin the application. After this, we can go in the admin panel, but first to go in the admin panel, we need to create the first user, the super user, the user for Django admin. This is do by write manage.py create super user, and with this code Django ask for username and password, and after this we can go in the admin panel. For example, if I can share with you for example to share this one. Okay. Okay. In our application, we can go in admin. And with the super user account, we have just ready all the admin table and all the table in CRUD mode created by the models. Then we can have this table is just ready with the user, I can create a new user, okay. For example, user one. Okay, there are some. Okay. Okay, and now I created the user. I can see the user on the table. I can give from this user also the right for admin, for example. Then it's just created from Django, this one. I have for example, I can. This is a table created by models. Then it is created by the models page. Then we have. We can manage it. And this is the admin panel. It's just really under the Django framework. The final is to create the REST application. I need to add in the setting.py file. I need to add REST framework because it just installed the REST framework. Then I need to create the serializer .py file, which will contain the models used to serialize the format. Then we need to create it. And I need to change the view.py to have the scenario to receive the web API and then what need to do. Then here the viewer receive the API and decide what is, for example, create the query set and go to select all the objects in the device. This is a table named dispositivo in Italian, device, and with object all create a query as select. Is a select query. Then return all the device, all the record in this table, and publish this with the serializer under the serial as a JSON format. Okay. Then we need to update also the URLs by to assign the invocation path, because also Lavio communicate with URLs to point at the web API called, and then is that is all. Okay, I just finish. If you have any question, I'm sorry for my English, but it's a lot of work, and the aim of this presentation is just to explain how we can help with Python and Linux environment in Serio. In this case, to create a NOST application without a lot of code in PC, and to access with all the device, all the devices. Okay, what do you mind showing us the serious side of things in a bit more detail? Okay, the Serio, Rodrigo, the Serio code in Visual Studio, or the Python code, or the Lavio code? Ah, good question. Okay, the Lavio code is very easy, because it's just a call by call the API. Okay, for example, this one is a login API to log to receive the token to communicate with application, and this one is URL to call the function to receive all the device. All the device in the table. Okay. Lavio code just need to have HTTP to call the API function. Okay, Rodrigo, I answer your question. Bye. If you want to view the code under the Serio, we can go under the okay. I will share with you the code of the application. Okay. Yes, Gabriel, the Lavio code is only the client calling the web API of the Django. Yes, yes. Is correct. I will share with you the view code, the Django code. Then, as you can see, there are the application is called NISO. The model. The model here is defined by import models. Okay, the models import import the Django that handle all the database part, then I can create by models, for example, have the field type. For example, in this class, I can. Did you see good the screen or not? My screen. Okay. If you see here, this is the model that create a table named dispositivo device, and the field I created the field, for example, a field named nome, import models from models. The char field is a string field, is a character field, okay? Then, if this is only in Django code, then I cannot if I explain well, but I hope yes. For me, is the good is that the framework manages the communication with the database. Then, if I want to take this code and place under a server in another place, and we use Postgres database, is not a problem. Just we need to have an account created to access in the Postgres. Okay, then I need to have the parameter to access in the Postgres. Then I go in the setting.py. I go in the database section. I change this one. The backend is based now on SQLite. And I change with, for example, Postgres. I think we need to not autocomplete this code, but need only to write Postgres. Then I need to have the parameter to access to the database, but the code of model not change. After this one, I need to redo the command migrate that change the database and also my migration to migrate create the database communication. With my make migrate, we take the models created by us and created the database, the table of this model. Okay, I think we need to, if you want to share some other question, we can go in the breakout session. Okay. I will thank you. I'm sorry for my English. I hope this is interesting for your work. And we need that to, in the future, we work another a lot to increase Django in CDO, because the space, for the question of space, is not a problem if you don't have a lot of code, just the package to Web API. Web API, Django, not a lot of this space consumed. I think 30 mega about. Okay. Thank you. And if something of you, we see you in the breakdown, in the breakout session. Sorry. Thank you. Bye.